Welcome! In this video, we'll break down how channel estimation and data equalization work in OFDM systems, key techniques behind technologies like 5G and Wi-Fi. We'll explain why they're needed, how they work, and show it all in action with a clear MATLAB simulation. Let's get started. In our last video on the OFDM cyclic prefix, we saw how multipath propagation, signals bouncing off buildings, trees, or other obstacles, creates multiple delayed copies of the transmitted signal. This causes inter-symbol interference, which distorts the received constellation. We also showed how adding a cyclic prefix helps reduce this distortion by protecting each symbol. But real-world wireless channels are even more complex. Signals can also reflect off moving objects like cars or people. When that happens, the Doppler effect occurs, shifting the frequency of the signal and introducing phase and amplitude distortions in the received data. So while the cyclic prefix handles timing issues, it doesn't fix everything. To truly recover the transmitted data, we need to understand how the channel has affected the signal and then reverse those effects. This is where channel estimation comes in. It allows the receiver to model the impact of the channel and then equalize the data, restoring it as closely as possible to its original form. Now let's take a closer look at how we estimate the channel. The signal we receive is essentially the convolution of the transmitted waveform with the channel's impulse response, which captures all the delays, reflections, and distortions introduced by the environment. From our earlier video on convolution, you might remember that in the frequency domain, convolution becomes simple multiplication. That means the received signal in the frequency domain is just the transmitted signal multiplied by the channel's frequency response. So, in theory, we can estimate the channel by dividing the received frequency domain symbols by the transmitted ones. But here's the catch. We don't know the transmitted data. That's what we're trying to recover. To solve this, OFDM systems embed known reference signals, often called pilots, into specific positions in the resource grid. These pilot symbols are predefined and known to both the transmitter and the receiver. At the receiver, we extract these pilots, which have been affected by the channel, and divide them by the original known values. This gives us the channel frequency response, but only at the pilot locations. To estimate the channel across the entire grid, we use 2D interpolation to fill in the gaps between pilot symbols. If you're unsure how interpolation works, check out our dedicated video for a quick refresher. Finally, once we have the full channel estimate, we simply divide the received OFDM symbols by this estimate, giving us the equalized data ready for demodulation and decoding. And that wraps up the theory. Now let's jump into MATLAB to see it all in action. We'll walk through the full simulation, generating the OFDM waveform, modeling a simple multipath channel with Doppler effect, performing channel estimation, equalizing the received signal, and finally calculating the bit error rate. You can find the MATLAB code linked in the video description. First, we set up our simulation parameters. We start by defining the OFDM grid size, the number of subcarriers and OFDM symbols. Then we choose the subcarrier spacing in hertz. For modulation, we use 256 QAM for user data and 4 QAM for the reference signals. We also set the cyclic prefix length to 12 samples. The sampling frequency is simply the number of subcarriers multiplied by the subcarrier spacing. Next, we generate the OFDM grid. We create random user data symbols, integers from 0 to 255, and map them to complex values using MATLAB's QAM modulation function. We pass a set of parameters, including the data symbols, modulation order, and symbol mapping, and set the average transmit power to 1 watt. If you're not familiar with these functions, be sure to check out our digital modulation series for a deeper explanation. We do the same for the reference signals, but using 4 QAM. Since they are not placed in every resource element, we reduce the size of the pilot grid by a factor of 4 in both time and frequency dimensions. Now we define the pilot positions, placing them in every fourth subcarrier and every fourth symbol. We also compute the positions of the user data symbols accordingly. Finally, we combine the modulated pilots and data into the resource grid and apply OFDM modulation to convert the signal into its time domain representation. To do this, we use an OFDM modulator function, passing in the grid along with a number of subcarriers and the cyclic prefix length. Let's pause here and plot the pilot and data constellations so we can see what they look like before transmission. As you can see, the 4 QAM constellation for pilots and the 256 QAM constellation for user data are clearly visible. Now let's simulate the effects of multipath propagation. We'll add two components, a line of sight path and a reflected path that is attenuated, time delayed, and frequency shifted to mimic a reflection from a moving object like a car. This introduces both delay spread and a Doppler shift, simulating real-world wireless conditions. After passing the signal through this channel, we demodulate the received OFDM waveform using MATLAB's built-in function and plot the resulting constellation. As you can see, the received symbols are clearly distorted, a direct result of the channel's effect on the transmitted signal. Next, we apply QAM demodulation to the received user data symbols to recover the transmitted bits. We then compare the demodulated symbols with the original transmitted ones to count the number of errors and calculate the symbol error rate. As you can see, the error rate is around 95%. Which means most of the user data is decoded incorrectly. This clearly shows how severe the impact of the channel is when we don't apply any channel estimation and equalization. To estimate the channel, we start by extracting the received pilot symbols from the OFDM grid. We then divide the received pilot values by the known transmitted pilots to compute the channel frequency response at those pilot positions. Next, we apply 2D interpolation, as demonstrated in our corresponding video, to estimate the channel across the entire OFDM grid. With the full channel estimate, we now equalize the received signal by dividing each symbol by the corresponding channel response and plot the resulting constellation. After equalization, we can see that the constellation diagram improves noticeably. And more importantly, the symbol error rate drops to below 10%. That's a significant improvement, showing just how effective channel estimation and equalization can be in restoring signal integrity. And that concludes the video. If you want to keep exploring the OFDM systems, be sure to check out our next video in the series. Thanks for watching.